How's it going, everyone? This is Trina Connor, and I'm your coach for the San Francisco Swamperts. This is the official start of Season 3 for the Indigo League of Legends, Week 1. This time, instead of battling my previous opponent, WMR, I'm actually facing Necro Steve this time around, as for the Indigo League of Legends, we encountered some issues with some people, which they had to drop out, and that forced us to reschedule a few things, but that's okay. For this battle, I'm going to be using Magmortar, Zygarde, Bastiodon, Cloyster, Hitmonchan, and Swordpuff. My opponent, Necrostevo, has a lot of threats, including his Mega Charizard Y, Croagunt, Rotom, Togekiss, all those Pokemon. They're going to be a huge problem for my team, which my team is just a little underused, I guess, because these are Pokemon that are not really good, per se, but we'll make it work. Alright, so I'm going to start with Firewalker, the Magmortar, go for the Flamethrower. I get a critical hit on the Togekiss Sky Dancer, which that tells me that this is a specially defensive Togekiss that we're looking at here. And so knowing that, okay, I can go into Zygarde and hit him with some Stone Edges. But before we do that, we're going to set up some Coils. As I was expecting him to go with a Dazzling Gleam or Protect, he goes for Dazzling Gleam. I take that. I knew I could live any one move from it because of Zygarde's bulk. And now we're ready to go with the Stone Edge, which is boosted by Coil. We raise the accuracy and the power of Stone Edge in this scenario. His Forest Choice comes in. I was expecting him to go with a Stealth Rock, or the Stealth Rocks, and some Spikes as well. And that's why we're here with Hitmonchan, because Hitmonchan has access to Rapid Spin. Rapid Spin can get rid of those entry hazards. However, I cannot go for it yet because of Rotom. Being a Ghost type means I cannot go for Rapid Spin as it is immune to it. I'm forced to go with Fire Punches here. And that's really unfortunate because this gives my opponent's Rotom a great chance to shine here because he goes for Will-O-Wisp, which cuts down my attacking power, and he goes for Pain Split. Not something I want to see, but it happened. So I was like, you know what, gosh darn it, I'm going to just keep going for Fire Punches. I really want to go for Rapid Spin at some point, and we might get a chance to do that because, believe it or not, Hitmonchan is faster than Togekiss. So, we're going to go for Rapid Spin, get rid of those entry hazards for now. And I knew he was going to go for Wish, because why not, right? Although, at the same time, look at his health. Look at his health. It's at full, almost. So, I'm not really sure why he went for the Wish in the first place. But that's okay. Here, I go into Bastille, the Bastiodon. I was expecting Gekko to say, okay, he might go, or the Bastiodon might go for the Iron Head, which is super effective against Togekiss, being Fairy Flying. I expected that, so I go with the Toxic to poison the Zapwing. But, you know, the Wish is still active at this point, which means Rotom's health will be restored. I go back into Firewalker, and he goes for Shadow Ball. I think he expected that, which is like, okay, this is not good, because I'm now playing kind of conservative or kind of obvious right now. So I was like, okay, maybe he'll just continue going for Shadow Balls or something. But he goes for a Volt Switch. So that's a great prediction on his part. And now he goes into his Charizard, which now he can safely Mega Evolve. I stay and go for a Wish, expecting him to, like, over-predict or something weird like that. But that was a real ballsy move on my part, as the Fire Blast is coming, but I do dodge it, which is, like, great, because I can now go for a Wish, and I can pass it to my Firewalker, who is suffering a lot of HP there. we're going to restore it. However, this Charizard Y goes for Earthquake, and she's super effective against Magmortar. Yeah, I'm playing kind of terrible right now, right? But you know what? It's okay, because now we can go in the cloister and set up some shell smashes. Or just one, actually. So we go with the shell smash as I have a focus sash to live any one move. And because the stealth rocks are gone, I can definitely live any one move. If stealth rocks were up, I would die to the fire blast. I have some very crappy luck with the move rock blast as I keep missing it. So now I'm like, okay, to ensure that we don't miss our moves, we'll go with icicle spear, which definitely has a 100% chance of not missing. So I was really expecting him to go with a gyro ball. And like right here, I was like, really? I missed another rock blast? This is insane stuff right here. So here we're going to just continue going for the icicle spear. And I was like, you know what? I'm not gonna trust the rock blast anymore. I'm done. But that's a little unfortunate because now with the forest is gone, he can just go into his Crawdon, and Crawdon is a monster. Because of priority, the Aqua Jet, I really should have stayed in and let Cloyster go down. Because I have to take all that energy hazards coming in with my Swirlpuff. And that means that Swirlpuff isn't really going to do much from this point on in this battle. But we do get some residual damage with the Life Orb recoil that the Crawdon is holding. So that's a thing, right? But all those energy hazards on the field, Crawdon can have like a field day because all he has to do is go for Aqua Jet and KO my Pokemon. So we lose Zygarde, a little unfortunate there, but at the same time, we can hopefully take out the Crawdon when he goes for a superpower here. I thought I could live it for some reason with my Bastion, because Bastion has a lot of HP and a lot of defense investment, and its overall bulk is fantastic as well. But yep, in this scenario, we get a double down. But I'm losing a lot of Pokemon in this battle, which means, okay, my last Pokemon is Cloyster, and all those energy hazards are going to take me down. So that's a 4-0 victory for my opponent. We did the best we could. I mean, I guess I wasn't fully prepared, I'll say, but it's week one. We'll hopefully adjust to it. But that was still a fun match. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I'm using some very unconventional Pokemon in this battle, or in this entire League of Legends, I'll say. So this is just a learning experience for the San Francisco Swamperts. I don't know if I'm going to be posting anything else before Christmas, but if I do, then that's cool. But if I'm not, then I wish you guys a Merry Christmas, Happy Holidays, and I will see you guys all next time. All right, goodbye, trainers.